What's up, guys? Welcome back to today's episode. It is freezing. It is about 28 degrees right now. We are in Carlsbad, New Mexico at the Pecos River, as you can see behind me. They got a little bit of a dam over here behind the camera, so I'm going to be trying to fish this whole area. Today I'm going to be using corn, power bait, and maybe some gold minnows, anything I got in my tackle bag. Not sure what's in here. I seen a guy pull a trout out over there just a minute ago, so maybe there's some trout in here. So we're gonna be throwing everything we got, and hopefully we land some fish today. It's supposed to warm up to like 50 degrees, so I'm kind of excited for that, because right now it's pretty cold. But I'm gonna get all rigged up and get baited, and we'll see what we pull in today. Got him, whatever it is. Oh, darn it, he came off. Oh, I had him hooked pretty good. I didn't set the hook too hard because it's a circle hook. Darn it. Let's get it rebedded and get back in there. Oh, he's tugging on it. Come on, give me a good bite. Oh, yanked it from him. Darn it. Darn it, darn it. Oh, got it, whatever it is. Oh, this sucker's been toying with me forever. What is it? What is it? What is it? Hey, it's a trout. It's a trout. Sorry, buddy. Whew. Take my glove off. Wet my hand. Whew. Heck yeah. Let's get you in the light. That is sweet. He's a good sized trout. Hold on, hold on. Hooked him in the bottom of the mouth. Look at that, guys. That is a gorgeous trout. There must be a lot of them in there. This is a good sized trout. It's probably my biggest one so far. Alright, I ain't keeping none of these guys, so that's why I wet my hand. I'm gonna let him go. All right, buddy, about the best release I could do for you. There he goes. That's freaking awesome. Whew, today's gonna be a good day. Let's catch some more. Okay, I don't know if this dude got me snagged. It felt like it was moving, but nope, it's not. He got me snagged. Fish on, fish on. Oh no, he's still there, he's still there, he's still there. Keeping pressure on him. It's another trout. Oh, come on, Bubba. Man, these are some beautiful fish. All right, wet my hand. There we go. Gosh dang, these things fight like crazy. Woo, this one's a hair smaller than the other one. Easy, buddy, easy, buddy. Gosh almighty, they're like slimy. There we go. Man, look how beautiful these fish are. I don't know how well the colors show up on camera, but man, these are some gorgeous, gorgeous fish. That is awesome. Back into the water when she came. Easy now, easy, easy. All right, here we go. And you're off. Man, these trout put up a hell of a fight. That's cool. And I'm not doing anything here special, folks. I got like four kernels on a circle hook with a slip sinker rig. And I'm casting it out there probably 15, 20 yards. Not casting it out too far. Let it sink to the bottom. And I just kind of tighten up my slack on my rod, and I kind of hold it. And you just wait for the bites. After that, it's all about timing on trying to set your hook a little bit when they're biting it. Got another one on, or had one. Nope, he's still on. He's just really small. A lot smaller than the other ones. This water still surprises me how freaking clear it is. I'm used to fishing like in Buffalo where it's like nasty green, but I'll wet our hands. That way we can let this guy go and he won't die on us. So we're gonna think about these trout, man. They're slimy and they're strong. They're a pain to handle. You can't really lip them like bass. Well, you can, but I don't want to hurt these guys. Want to let them go. But a gorgeous little fish. This one's only like 8 inches. It's kind of small, but they are pretty fish. Real pretty fish. Freaking awesome. This is my third one for the day. On corn, man. Simple as that. All right, buddy. There you go. Off he swims. He's still right there. Freaking sweet, dude. I can't get enough of it. Oh, this one hit it like a freaking train. It felt like a freaking 5-pound bass when this dude hit it. He must have picked it up and took off with it, man. Another trout. This dude was feisty. Oh, let's wet our hands again without making my chubby butt fall in the water. It was a nice one. I bet you'd like to see me fall in the water, huh? It's cold. Too cold to be falling in water, I'll tell you that much. All right, let's get a hold on you, buddy. That way you don't hurt yourself or me. Get this nice little circle hook out of you. Look at that. Gorgeous, gorgeous trout. He peed a little bit. Ooh, he's peeing. Must be happy to see me. Happens all the time. Oh man, number four for the day. Freaking awesome. Oh, let's let him go. All right, there you go, buddy. Go back where you belong. There he goes, swims off. Woo, let's get another one. I'm freaking excited, this is awesome. Oh, getting a couple bites. Oh, dang it. Ah, missed him. Darn it. Huh? Let's get back out there. As soon as it hits the water, they're already biting on it again, and I missed him again. Jesus. Oh, I need to take up knitting or something. I suck at fishing. Same thing doesn't even hit me in the water like more than 10 seconds before you got a nice trout on. This is awesome. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. All right. There's a fire. Oh, wet our hands. Jesus, another fat one. Gosh dang. For some reason, the audio didn't record on the last fish, but he was about this big too. Man, this dude's a donger. A donger? A what? A big fish is what I meant to say. A big trout. Oh man, this is freaking cool. Oh, fish on. And I forgot my mic. So I took my mic off a little bit ago to clean it and I didn't put it back on, so the audio on this probably sounds horrible. But it's a nice trout nonetheless. Oh, come here. Oh darn, he got off. Oh, that sucks. That sucks. He could tell. He knew I didn't have my microphone. He's like, nope, that's not good quality. Not good quality audio. You can't put that on YouTube. Well, I just had that fish on power bait. This morning, man, they were smashing the corn. And then all of a sudden, they just quit. I mean, all them other fish I caught on corn. So I tried the fireballs and didn't get no bites on that. And that last trout was caught on this orange power bait. So I guess it's what they're hitting on for now. So I guess we'll keep using this, see what happens. Well, the power bait definitely smashing it. That's definitely what they want, I can tell you that much. Went from corn to, gosh almighty, I lost another one. Well, I think I know why. I had a small circle hook and I switched to this little bitty like size 10 J hook. And now that I've switched there, I lost both of those fish. Well, back to the circle hook. That went on the corn. They quit biting on the power bait and the corn nailed this one. I ain't letting this one get off though. Oh, come on, bud. He's not big, but he's a trout. Woo, feisty. See, back on the circle hook. I didn't lose him with a circle hook. I'm gonna take all my J hooks and throw them in the trash. Just kidding, they cost money. But I don't want to take the slam off of you. Look at that, guys. Beautiful trout. This makes number, well, with losing those two, it's actually my seventh one. But with those two I just lost, it's nine. Easy, buddy. Let's let you go. Back in the water. There he goes. Sweet. No harm, no foul. Well, guys, that wraps it up for this episode. We wound up catching quite a few trout. I usually catch one or I get skunked. So this trip turned out to be pretty successful, I might say. Using corn caught majority of the trout, and learned to stick with circle hooks, stay away from J hooks. It was kind of, might have been coincidence, but we'll stick with the circle hooks. Anyways, like I said, I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you could, hit the like, subscribe button, share the channel. It always helps us out, and we will see y'all in the next video.